Dear students, now we are going to discuss orbital elements in satellite communication. There are six orbital elements used to define the artificial satellite orbit in space. These elements are also called as Hubblerian element set. The elements are semi-major axis, eccentricity, mean anomaly, argument of perigee, inclination and right ascension of the ascending node. In this, the first two elements, semi-major axis and eccentricity, are used to represent the shape of the satellite orbit. Mean anomaly is used to represent the position of the satellite in space. Argument of perigee is used to represent the rotation of the satellite. Inclination and right ascension of the ascending node. These two parameters are used to represent the position of orbit with respect to Earth. Okay, so let's discuss each type in detail here. The first one is semi-major axis. In general, the path of the satellite is elliptical path. So here, the horizontal line represents major axis. Vertical line represents minor axis. The half of the major axis is known as semi-major axis. So it is the distance from the center of an ellipse to the edge of the ellipse. Okay, so that is the semi-major axis. It defines the shape of the satellite orbit. Okay, so next one is eccentricity. Eccentricity is the optical parameter which gives the shape of satellite orbit, that is the deviation of the shape from a perfect circle. So it can be obtained from the formula square root of a squared minus b squared by a. Here a is the semi-major axis, b is the semi-minor axis. So here, based on this value, the shape of the satellite orbit is defined. Okay, so here, whenever this eccentricity value is between 0 to 1, it will be the elliptical path. So if eccentricity is equal to 0, that is circular path. If its value is equal to 1, it becomes parabola. If the value is greater than 0, less than 1, it is the elliptical path. Okay. So for satellite communication, for an elliptical path, the value of eccentricity is greater than 0, less than 1. Okay. Next one is mean anomaly. It is represented as capital M. It is mainly used to represent the angular position of the satellite in its orbit with reference to the perigee point at a reference time. It can be calculated using the formula m naught is equal to n into t minus tp. Here t is the reference time, n is the mean motion, tp is the time of perigee passage. Okay, so here mean anomaly is used to represent the angular position of the satellite. Okay, so the next one is argument of perigee. So here it is represented as omega. It is an angle from this ascending node to the perigee at the Earth center in the direction of satellite motion. So here, ascending node is the point where the satellite orbit crosses this equatorial plane from south to north. Okay, so that is known as ascending node. So here starts from this line of nodes. Line of nodes means the line joining ascending and descending node through the center of Earth. Okay, so here argument of perigee is the angle from this ascending node to this perigee to the center of Earth in the direction of satellite motion. So it is mainly used to give the rotation of the orbit's perigee point. It is related to this line of nodes. Okay, so argument of perigee is mainly used to give the rotation of orbit's perigee point. Okay, so the next one is inclination. So what is mean by inclination here? It is the angle between satellite orbit plane and the equatorial plane. Here it is mainly used to give the orbital plane's position with respect to the earth. Okay, so this is the inclination point. So it gives the orbital plane's position with respect to the earth. Okay, last one is right ascension of the ascending node. Simply run RAAN. It is represented as omega. Here this is the satellite orbit plane. This one is the equatorial plane. Okay. So here this RAAN is mainly used to define the accurate position of the orbit in space. So how is it possible? So it can be measured eastward in the equatorial plane from vernal equinox direction. So that is gamma line. It is also called as vernal equinox direction to the ascending node. So here this ascending node is not always permanent because the satellite is continuously rotating as well as the earth revolves around the sun. So here we can consider this gamma line, that is equinox line, is an imaginary line drawn from this equatorial plane crossing through the center of the sun first time. So here we can assume the first point of Aries as the imaginary line for this RAN calculation. So that's very very important point here. So here we can say this RAN relates the orbital plane's position to the earth, mainly used to define the accurate position of the orbit in space. So it is the angle measured eastward in the equatorial plane from this equinox direction to the ascending node. So this is the imaginary line drawn from the equatorial plane which is crossing through the center of the sun first time. Okay, that is very important point here.